I am an alien, and at times I get reminiscent about the first time I touched base with technology. The first email I created was a Yahoo account. The first phone I used was a Nokia 3310. The first social media accounts I created were on Orkut and MySpace. At the peak of their business, all these companies enjoyed a strong first mover advantage, an enviable user base, an unrivaled brand equity, and unparalleled capital access. Yet, many of these firms are struggling. In fact, some of these don't even exist today. Let's try and analyze what went wrong. At the base of a company's continued success is its ability to provide continued enhanced support and utility to its users. This decisive battle between two mammoths of social media is an example of a company's failure because of its denial to change. It was a great experience to create a profile on Orkut, add friends, send them messages and post on their scrapbook, but what next? Nothing. On the other hand, Facebook grasped the requirements of its users and continuously evolved. It included third parties, it added games to its web panel website, and then it went on to include chat messages and messenger and evolved continuously. This graph shows the success of a software product against time. As time goes on, users find declining utility of a software product because their expectations from the software product keep on increasing. If a company does not change, it starts to go down through the slope of drift, and if it continues to be in a denial mode, it goes on to repent because it's too late to implement any changes then. It is in the interest of a company to continuously enhance its software product or offerings so that it can continue to implement and continue to live up to the expectations of its users. It will have to change, and these are the types of changes a software product will undergo in its life cycle. Some changes are because of tech upgrades, that are upgrades related to the technology on which the software is built. Others are related to the disruptions on the technology on which the software is built, and the others are related to business, perhaps because of a competitor having more competitive product. Tech upgrades are browser upgrades or OS upgrades, security threats, or possibly UI UX trends that are changing, possibly flat design that came up in 2013, a Heartbleed attack that was a recent security threat, and browser upgrades and OS upgrades are very frequent and should be known to everyone. Disruptions like artificial intelligence, Internet of Things, virtual reality and augmented reality, possibly virtual reality and augmented reality are going to take up the gaming, the games and the gaming industry. They're going to cause a great disruption over there. The third kind of changes are changes related to business logic. That is a competitor coming up with a great product and forcing all other players to implement those changes or enhance their products. Perhaps changes related to consumer requirements and diversification and product enhancements. This case study is a great example of the agility of a product, agility of a firm. In 2013, WeChat planned to launch in India. WeChat is a Chinese firm that is an instant messaging application, a social media application, and an e-commerce application all in one. It's very famous in China. WeChat decided to come up in India as a part of its expansion strategy and also hired biggest Bollywood celebrities and launched an aggressive marketing campaign in India. The unique selling proposition against WhatsApp was their tap to talk function that enabled people to send voice messages over phone using data. WhatsApp at that time did not support voice messages. WeChat started to gain a lot of traction, at least in India, because it allowed even a 3-year-old or a 2-year-old child to send messages using a phone. WhatsApp started to get, you know, WhatsApp started to panic because it was because WeChat was using its user base and WhatsApp was losing a lot of its users. Within a few weeks, WhatsApp came up with a new feature that would allow everyone to send voice messages, and that's the same that we have today. This is a great example of agility. Of course, change is inevitable, growth is optional. When there are competitors in the market, when there are several technology platforms, there is going to be change and you are going to have to embrace change. How a company takes change is up to its strategy. If it takes change as an opportunity to enhance its product offerings to its customers, offer better services, it's going to grow. Otherwise, it's going to go down the repentance path. Since change is absolutely imminent, it's certainly, it's of course not an easy decision. There are several complexities involved, technology complexity, as in if a firm is able to implement the changes or the new technology that has come in. There's certainly a cost involved. Perhaps the new technology is very costly. Say artificial intelligence is a very costly thing. It costs a lot of money to buy the data, implement software, all from scratch again. Ongoing business, the impact of ongoing business, perhaps you have to delay support of the ongoing business to embrace or accept or develop software on a new technology, and it causes delays. Also, there are existing investments about which a company is concerned. For example, Nokia delayed building smartphones using Android for quite a lot of time, and it went on until it was quite too late and it was lagging. And it's when it started building smartphones using Android, it was too little too late. Availability of human resources is again another challenge. If there are no human resources available on the new technology, a firm has to recruit and hire human resources, and it costs a lot of money. It makes sense because change is inevitable, and it makes sense to build future-proof solutions. Future-proof solutions take into account the technology disruptions, technology upgrades, and business logic changes that are going to come into the future. And it's kind of anticipating change or anticipating future and keep a gate open for the future upgrades that are to come. A future-proof solution preserves business logic so that technology disruption is indifferent, so that the solution is indifferent to the technology disruption that is going to come. A future-proof solution is independent of technology, as in it isolates business logic from technology so that it can use the same business logic over and over again to implement the same product irrespective of the technology. Because business logic is isolated from implementation or the technology in which business logic is mentioned is not the same as that of implementation, human resource training is not required over and over again. Future of work is the identification of advancements in automation that allow us to leverage those automations to do the tasks that are done by human beings. For example, our day-to-day jobs, a developer, a customer support executive, a doctor. In fact, some hospitals are now using bots to identify diseases, for example, skin cancer. Future of work is implemented in two models. One is an augmented workforce, that is a supervised workforce, a bot. When a bot fails to pursue a particular task, it delegates that task to a human expert. The other model is completely automated, that is the bot does everything and there's no delegation to a human expert. Software development works best with augmented workforce. The future, again, belongs to those who embrace the culture of adoption, and future of work is Again, integration of human and bots. I invite you to embrace the future of work and build future-proof solutions and shape your future. Thank you.